In this video, we are focusing on Grandmaster Wang Ziping. He was born in 1881 and lived until 1973. During his life, he has revived the title, The Lion of Chinese Kung Fu. Even though both his father and grandfather were famous martial artists, they refused to teach Ziping. They did not want him to experience the suffering they had to go through. Wang Ziping, on the other hand, was passionate about it and started to train on his own when he was 7 years old. He made the decision to travel around the country. During his trip, he was chosen to train under the Wushu master Yang Hongshu. Many dared to challenge him in a fight, but he remained undefeated. German workers, a group of judo practitioners, and an American named Sullivan could not beat him. After the 1949 revolution, he was respected as a hero and was appointed as deputy to Shanghai's Congress, vice president of the National Wushu Association, and as a member of the All China Sports Federation. Islam in China is well documented, with the Hui people acting as the largest Muslim minority within the country. From approximately 19 years after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a relationship between China and Arabia was already in place. It was the third Khalifa, Osman, who initiated the first conscious efforts to spread Islam in the region, with subsequent trade missions also contributing to the spread of Islam. The Hui Muslims came from this lineage, a unification of Arabia and China, to form this unique position of authentic Chinese culture infused with the Islamic tradition, the likes of which can still be seen to this day in various parts of the country, though mostly concentrated in the northwestern parts of China. The practice of martial arts still takes place in various mosques around the country, with Islamic sciences being taught at the same time. Not only did martial arts combine with practical aspects of defense for long seafaring trade missions, but it also was a spiritual tool of many Muslim masters. The need for self-control and restraint is reflected in both martial arts and traditional Islamic teachings. The concept of Islamic self-control was used by martial arts masters in the physical realm as well, with practitioners putting emphasis on both spiritual and physical aspects of training. The need for calm and collected decision-making is a tradition upheld by Muslims, as seen in the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The strong is not the one who overcomes the people by his strength, but the strong is the one who controls himself while in anger. The essence of ijtihad in maintaining self-discipline is integral in both paths. Various art forms such as silat and wushu have been perfected by the Muslims over the last few hundred years, with many original martial arts being either created or adapted by Muslims as well, such as Zakuan and Piguquan. These original developments were tools that were created often by army officials or for the purpose of safeguarding Muslims in China, being passed down in secret through generations. In the history of this marriage between martial arts and Islam, there are many names such as Wang Ziping and Cheng Teng Cheng, who trained in their discipline while retaining their faith and using it as a means to come closer to Allah and the teachings of their religion. Master Wang Ziping, acknowledged as a master of wushu, was also a deeply religious man who was very knowledgeable about the teachings of Islam. He was known to lift heavy stones while reciting the Quran. A notable story tells of his opposition to German forces who attempted to obtain the doors of King Zhao Masjid that was inscribed with the history of the Muslims in China. Master Wang was not one to let a priceless part of Muslim identity be taken away, and so he challenged the soldiers to a weightlifting competition, which he ended up winning. A master of various other disciplines, Wang Ziping was an inspiration to Muslims and non-Muslims alike. His mastery of a variety of martial arts allowed him to defeat many foreign opponents, leading to a great following of students, thus also spreading Islam amongst Chinese people. In reality, martial arts and the Islamic tradition share a unique bond in history that, within them, both contain means to achieve a greater purpose. Acting as reflections of each other, the history of Islam in China led to the expansion of the religion to the far eastern corners of the world. And the practical nature of martial arts helped defend this tradition in a way that kept the uniqueness of Chinese culture with the absoluteness of the religion of Islam.